So I'm Verity Geere from the Magic 105.4 Breakfast Show. Morning. And I'm very excited to be chatting to E.L. James, the author of the fastest selling book of 2012. How proud are you of that title?
Well, it's, I'm a bit gobsmacked by that, frankly. Yes, very, very, wow.
Well, like so many other people, I haven't been able to put it down so far, and I'm only on the first book.
Okay.
So, I mean, first of all, what on earth inspired you?
I was inspired. I'd read a few BDSM novels, and I just as you do, like you do, and I won't explain what that is on air. I just thought, what if you wanted to, met someone who wanted to do this, and you didn't? What would happen? And they always mentioned the paperwork as well, and I thought, what paperwork? What's the paperwork? This is in these novels, and I thought, well, I'm going to find out what the paperwork is, and I wanted to publish a contract. So that's what I set out to do.
So when it came to your research, did you manage to find people that would open up to you?
I spoke via email to one person who was very forthcoming, shall we say. And I also did a lot of Googling of various bits and pieces. So, yes, I found out a lot of stuff on the interwebs.
Because I think there's a book in everybody, isn't there? What made you think, right, this is what my book's going to be about?
Well, it just happened to be. It was actually the fourth one that I'd actually written. I'd started writing after I read Twilight. I'm a huge Twilight fan. I'm a complete Twihard. And I'd read all the books and reread them back in, it was Christmas 2008. And I sat down and wrote a novel. And then I wrote another novel. And then I wrote another one, and then I wrote a version of what this eventually became. So it was that's what inspired me. Completely.
So you don't mind people calling it Twilight for adults?
Well, no, I don't. I mean, what a comparison. It's Stephanie Meyer's a huge influence for me.
Because, I mean, when I'm reading it, I'm thinking of already what's the film going to be like.
Yeah.
When you were writing it, were you thinking this could really be something quite special here?
No, of course not. I wrote it for fun. I wrote it for me more than anything else. No, I had no idea that I'd get this kind of response. I'm still can't quite believe it. And the response in the States has been phenomenal as well. So it's trying to just wrap my head around it. It's kind of difficult. So I just don't. It's actually easier not to. So I'm just going with the flow.
And because it's had a really good reaction to people, apparently, in their private lives as well, encouraging more activity in the bedroom.
Definitely.
How do you feel about that?
I think that's great. What can I say? I mean, great stuff. You know, the things that bring people together, make them, talk to each other, share more intimacy. I mean, what greater compliment is that?
Because maybe I'm naive, but I am reading it thinking, does this really happen?
Yeah, it does.
is fiction?
It is fiction. Yes. Yes. I mean, the novel itself. I mean, I'm not quite sure what you mean. Does this really happen? Do incredibly wealthy men know how to fly helicopters, sailboats, and gliders? Well, you know, that's a bit of a question mark over that. But this kind of relationships, yes, they go on a lot, and I think you'd be surprised.
Why did you set it in Seattle?
For various reasons. I mean, basically, I used to read a lot of romantic novels when I was in my early 30s as a travelling in on the tube. And there's a woman called Elizabeth Lau, one of my favourite novelists, who sets a lot of her work in Seattle. So kind of from that.
So you spent time there? Or?
No.
No?
I've never been to Seattle.
Wow.
I've never been to Paula. Google Street View, though. Fantastic. You can drive around there. It's great.
Because, I mean, that's one of the things I'm excited about in the film now, is it's going to be a beautiful setting.
I hope
not
so.
Not just beautiful people, but...
I hope so.
Yeah.
It'll rain a lot. That's the trouble. But, yeah, we'll see.
And have you got any idea who you would cast? Because there's a load of names flying around the internet.
I am not saying anything about casting.
Okay. Because there's a lot of people putting themselves forward, isn't there?
Yeah, that's been fun.
I just don't think anybody on earth is good looking enough. I think it's a really tall order to be as gorgeous as Christian Kirk. So, yeah, I mean, particularly when it comes to the film as well, like doing the sex scenes. I mean, is it going to be something that you won't be able to see at the cinema or...?
Well, hopefully it's a film, so we're going to put it out in the cinema. So, yes, we'll have to. They'll just have to be handled very carefully. That's one of the reasons why we went with Focus, that they've done this kind of difficult material before.
Now, not only have you become an inspiration for readers in the bedroom, but I think you have inspired people to get
reading.
Writing as well.
As well, and reading too. I get so many people who said, I haven't read a book since college. In fact, someone who sent me a tweet saying, I've never read a book. And I thought, my God, how have you got through life doing that? But I've never read a book, and now I've read 3 in 2 weeks, you know. And that's extraordinary. And yes, people have started writing, what can you do? That's just such a compliment when people say, you've inspired me to write.
What do your family think?
They're all incredibly proud. They're a bit gobsmacked and bemused like me, frankly. We're all sort of sitting there going, okay, this is it. And just talking to my kids this morning saying, oh, well, I've got to go and do this, and then I've got to go and do this. Oh, yeah, right, okay, Mum, I've got football or whatever. They're just taking it in their stride.